Welcome, welcome to Angry Appliance Repair Puzzle. For the record, you're looking at them. So, this presentation is going to be about electric smooth tops. We are going to talk about cookware and smooth tops. One of the questions that I get from homeowners all the time when I'm in the house working on something is, why do I have links around my burners? Well, I scrub and scrub and scrub with the stuff that I buy at the store that I am supposed to use, but it doesn't take the rings off. Most of the time, the rings on the smooth tops come from the cookware. The cookware is the wrong kind of cookware to fit that stove. So, there are three things to try to remember when you are using cookware on a smooth top, or you want to buy new cookware for your smooth top, either way. Number one, most of the smooth tops these days have very different size burners. Some burners will be small, some will be large. And the large burners are actually expandable, where there'll be a switch that you can make it a 6-inch, an 8-inch, a 10-inch, a 12, a 14. I've even seen 16-inch burners that they use to help with cookware. So when you have an 8-inch burner, for example, you want to use approximately an 8-inch pot. So on the bottom of the pot, where you look and see, some are marked with the sizes, some you use a tape measure, and you figure out what the size of the burner is and the size of the cookware. The bigger the cookware, obviously you want to put it on the bigger the burner. So with the burner itself, when you are trying to judge, you want the cookware to just about match the size of the burner on the stove. You don't want to put a small pot on a big one. What that will do is possibly burn a spot in there. The heat needs to be on the burner, not on the glass. So if the cookware is bigger than the burner, the cookware gets hot, of course. It makes the glass around the burner hot, and that can create a ring. So the better the size of the cookware to the burner, that it's a good fit, whether it's 16-inch, 14-inch. So when you are buying new cookware, you see the size of the stove burners that you have to make sure you get the right stuff, or vice versa. If you are going to buy a new smooth top range, you can see what kind of cookware you have so you know what size, because most of the features of an electric range smooth top is the size of the burners. So the more expensive ones, of course, give you more choices for what burners to have and how much cookware, small or large, that you can use. So cookware needs to match the size of the burner. That's number one. Number two, flat. The cookware needs to be flat. So when you have the cookware cannot have anything on the bottom of it that would not have it make good contact with the glass. It needs to be flat, flat, flat. Now, there are plenty of things out there that I don't like being flat. I like curves. I like bumps just like the next guy does. I like looking at things that are curvy. I like looking at things that are not flat. Looking at things flat can sometimes not be very entertaining. But in this case, it must be. What are you asking me, smartest man? Well, I don't know what's curvy, a mountain range or something. Something that has some curves and has something to look at. What fun is it looking at something that's flat? I know that. But in this case, with cookware, it must be flat. You do not want it to wobble. It must sit firm on the counter, so then it will sit firm on the cookware. So the flatter the cookware is, the better it will work. So it needs to be flat. Some manufacturers will put their symbols on the bottom of the cookware. That's not good. When they put the symbols on the bottom, it can actually create a spot on the burner because it gets too hot, because it's not making contact with the glass. So the flatter the pot is, the better. And made of the proper material, which brings me to number three. Cast iron and glass are not recommended to put on this. As most people know, cast iron takes a long time to heat up. The warmer the cast iron gets, the more that the glass gets hot to the touch, and that can damage the glass. That's why they do not like cast iron. It's heavy and you can scratch if you drag it. Glass on glass isn't a very good idea either. Stainless steel or aluminum. Most manufacturers make stainless steel or aluminum cookware. That is basically what you buy anyway. So as long as you stick to that. So stainless steel or aluminum is good. Being flat in this case is good. And having the right size burner and the right size pot that they match is good. If you do those three things, the stove will keep its appearance many, many years into the future. And when you have a good conductivity between the glass and the cookware with those three things, it boils very quickly. If you think your smooth top is not working very well because it's taking too long to boil, that could be because the cookware is not on the glass properly. So, the senile thought each week, this time is going to be about upgrades. A lot of times I get into people's homes and they say, I'll use the stove as an example, since that's what we're talking about. I open my oven door and my light does not come on, but yet my old one did. Well, believe it or not, that is an upgrade today. A lot of manufacturers will keep their price down on their products by cutting away some of the things that we called standard 20 years ago. When I was a wee little tot in the 60s, it would basically be the same for the ovens, where you'd open the door, the light would come on, the burners all look the same. They were very always expected to get those features. But nowadays, they will try to keep the price down by eliminating certain features. For example, you open the door, the oven light comes on. On your new one, you open the door, it doesn't come on. You need to find the switch. That they have changed to keep the price down. So when you are shopping for a stove, you may, if you ask, well, if I open the door, does my light come on? The salesman may say, no, not anymore, no. So then you have to buy one and pay more for it. Things that we took for granted that were there years ago will not necessarily be there on the new ones. And that will also be, of course, with the way they want to keep the price down, or at times the way that they make the products, and if it's self-clean, not self-clean, different story, talk about that some other time. But the way that the appliances and cars and toasters, you think that it has that with it, but you never ask. If the feature is important to you, ask, because nowadays it may not come on a standard product. You might have to buy an upline product, or an upgrade, excuse me, might have to buy an upgraded product to be able to get that feature that it had 20 years ago or so. So think about that. And thank you for spending some of your day with us.